morning, guys. Welcome to another day of 21 Days of Prayer. If you don't mind, I want to jump right into the Word this morning. We're going to be in Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 to 11. It says, when Jesus was led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil, after he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter approached him and said, if you're the Son of God, then tell these stones to become bread. And Jesus said, it is written, man must not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Then the devil took him to the holy city, had him stand on the pinnacle of the temple and said, well, if you're the Son of God, throw yourself down, for it's written, he will give you his angels' orders concerning you, and they will support you with their hands so that you won't strike your foot against a stone. Jesus said, it's also written, do not test the Lord your God. Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. And he said to Jesus, I will give you all these things if you fall down and worship me. And Jesus said, go away, Satan. It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Then the devil left him and angels came and began to serve him. Here's the thing, is that we all face temptation in life. If Jesus had to go through temptation, I don't know what it is that makes us think we're going to be exempt from temptation. Now, in the original language that this text was written in, the word temptation means to try whether a thing can be done. So the Satan's goal is always to turn us away from God's way. His goal is always to turn us away from God's way. And because we know that, because we know that Satan is a great deceiver, we have to know how to combat this. We have to know what it is that we can do to stand against temptation. And I'll tell you what that is. There's three things that we got to do. The first is this. We got to read God's word. We got to read God's word. Why? Because this is the primary way that God speaks to us. We cannot know God without his word. So we have to read his word because this is the primary way that he speaks to us. But beyond that, the second thing we have to do is know God's word. Now, there's a difference between knowing of God's word and knowing God's word. There's a lot of people that know of God's word. There's a lot of people that are going to die and go to hell that probably could quote to you John 3:16, but they don't necessarily know God's word. See, the reason we got to know God's word as opposed to just knowing of his word is because Satan will use anything that he can against us. And if he knows that we don't truly know the word, then we are toast, because he will try to use even that against us in the same exact way that he did Jesus. But see, Jesus is the word. And so clearly that means he knew the word because he had to know himself. And so when Satan tried to use those little scripture verses to get Jesus thrown off, Jesus said, well, the word also says this. See, because he knows the word, he knows the whole scope of it. So we also got to know God's word. This is where we take time and we need to begin to practice memorizing God's word. Psalm 119:11, the psalmist said, I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. Why did he hide God's word in his heart? It was so that he wouldn't sin against God. So that must mean that the cure to sin is having God's word hidden in our hearts. So when we begin to hide God's word in our heart, we can't just really stop there either. Now we got to actually take action and turn to the word. This is exactly what Jesus did. Every time Satan presented something to him, Jesus went right to God's word and he said, it is written. It says this. And we have to be able to do that because this is the path to defeating temptation. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13, the Apostle Paul says that no temptation has overtaken you except what's common to mankind. Then he says, God is faithful. He won't let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. But when you are tempted, he will also provide a way out so that you can endure it. Well, here's the deal. I believe that Apostle Paul meant that way out that God is going to provide is Jesus. Because the Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Not only does the Bible say that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, the Bible in John chapter 1 said that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And then it said that there was not a thing that has been made that was made without him. And then when you jump down to John 1:14, it said, then the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And it said, we've seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father. And guess what? He came from the Father full of grace and full of truth. Well, why is that? Why is that important, Monte? Well, because if Jesus is the Word and the Word is truth, that matters because we need the truth if Satan is going to be trying to deceive us. And so if Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and if Jesus is also the word, that means that the way out of our temptation has to be Jesus. And we get to Jesus through the word because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And guess what? I'm here to encourage you and let you know today that he is the way to defeat temptation. He actually won the ultimate victory beyond just our temptation when he rose from the grave after 3 days and he gave us the keys to death, hell, and the grave. And now we can be free of all temptation. But we can only be free if we are willing to read his word, to know God better. And then if we begin to hide his word in our hearts, we got to know God's word. And then once we know it, we can't just know it. We can't be people who merely hear the word. We can't be people who just practice all these memory verses. Then we got to take action and turn to the word just like Jesus did. And turning to the word means turning to Jesus, because Jesus is the word made flesh. He's the way, the truth, and the life. If you want to defeat temptation today, it's time to get in God's word. Thanks for listening. My name is Amonte King. I'm student ministry and worship pastor here at The River. And this week's focus is that God is our sustainer and provider. Let's go to God in prayer.